So.
Okay, then as the last speaker for today, Etienne wants to talk about how to use graph concepts in the medical domain. And as a surprise speaker, I'm pretty interested what you have
No,
to
thank you
answer.
for your last minute invitation. This project is an
Have to speak a bit louder because the microphone is only for the recording and not for the.
okay. This project is an experimental project in the scope of the open source working group of the International Society for Telemedicine. It's interactive medical mind maps. You could also call it a look at natural intelligence. The goal is to make in a visual to make a visual representation of medical information. The problem is that up to now, many medical record software were just narrative report like paper on screen. And my vision is that we have to move to a more task-oriented model. Of course, the goal is to help to solve the patient's health problem, not just to describe what did happen. And I want to have a visual support of that kind of what people are thinking, because it is important to talk to each other across the internet to understand what the other partner is thinking. It can be used for training of a student, and this mind synchronization is between members of care team across the internet in Africa of several thousand kilometers away. I'm missing a slide somehow. No, somehow it was not on the key. Okay. No. I don't.
Objectives? No traps.
No, okay. There
Oh, no traps.
is a graph, but you have seen many graphs today. That is not important. We have we make a graph with several kinds of things. Observation presented in yellow. Dus what has been observed, measured. There is no discussion about the blood pressure or any measurement. The health issue are the concern requiring attention, because medical records cannot contain everything about the patient. What are the concerns for this particular patient? The action are the decision what to do, either more exploration or treatment. And of course, at the later stage, we'll have links to medical knowledge, which more or less already exist in database, but not necessarily in Neo4j. The attribute of nodes and also of edges are very important, because we don't want to have a black or white report. We need the degree of belief. We need the importance, of course, from the judgment of the author, and many other attributes. Attributes can be a long text, but it is, I believe, the challenge is to make a graph representation in such a way that when a patient is coming, a patient I do not know from a colleague or from 1 year ago, on one screen, I want to have the essential things. Patient has five problems. We are doing that and that. And the problem today is maybe something new. Then, of course, we use navigation. Just the flying over a node will expand the content. Clicking on a node will move to related topics, and a right click will make possible to modify, add information. Just I just spoke about training a student. Of course, the medical records today are not in that way, but why not to make a transition and use a graph as a kind of table of content, and the node may contain a discharge letter. Why not? That is the idea. And well, I am looking for partner helping of this project. Of course, medical colleague, but here technical people, how to solve many challenge. There is a begin on GitHub, and well, the system is using D3 for the visualization with vis.js for the interactive presentation. You will find more information there, and please contact if you are interested. I need help. I am learning JavaScript and I am not very far. Thank you very much. Question?
Well, thank you for your presentation. You've listed the types of nodes on one of the slides, like attributes, observations, but there were no mention of the pharmacy. Did you plan or do you intend to go further with the fermentation and the medicine, basically? Yes. To connect the nodes with attributes
no.
and observations?
The node,
with the, treatment.
The group of nodes called action include many things you can ask for. You can ask for more information, ask for a lab, or you can ask for a drug, a prescription. And at this time, there is not yet very much developed, but there is an important use of graph about product interaction, and there are databases. I do not pretend to reinvent that, but to make an interface. Just the goal of this project is to have an interface during a consultation, and then you will move on other things. But to have a kind of synthesis, a one screen graph telling that the patient has hypertension and he's taking that drug and he has an infection and taking some antibiotics, and if there is any problems between these drugs, we have to show it on the first screen. Because in many situations you have 5 to 10 minutes for every patient. Just it must be really efficient, and there is, of course, a lot more to be done about presentation and human interface.
So this is your graph picture, right?
Ah, yes.
This is your app, actually.
Perhaps yes.
You can explain it here.
Yes, this you can move on some. And you get the detail. There is no yet real data there, and you can click on what did happen on a given day. There will be, of course, a trade-off. Some information has to be simply as attribute, in a key value, and other have to be real Neo4j. But do not think to put everything from in Neo4j, because then you have a very, very heavy graph.
I mean, if it's just simple attributes, then you can just put them there, so it doesn't really matter because it's
I hope you can change it. You can make a program modifying some things. With my vision is to have such a graph, and if later it is more efficient to change the structure, you can help to change the structure and keep the same information.
Yeah. What's interesting, we had a life sciences workshop in Berlin, and there was actually someone who had similar interests to yours from the Netherlands. Let me find it. That was here. Substantially improving healthcare. This one. Proteome. Yeah. So Peter van den Berg from MSNPL. And he had similar ideas to yours, and I think that would be definitely.
I don't know. Peter van den Berg.
Yeah, it would be definitely. Oops. Definitely interesting for you to look at what he's done, and I can put you into contact with him if you want to.
Yes, please.
So because he also wants to improve healthcare in general by adding more connected information to how treatments are done, diagnoses are done, how providers interoperate, how people treat drug dependencies. So for instance, if you have like side effects and stuff like that, and if you have all these connections available for decision making, then it's much easier to make good decisions for your patient. And they come from critical wound care clinics, so in the Netherlands. So that's really interesting.
Okay. And of course, there is today not yet many data, but at a later stage, of course, pattern recognition will follow, but first make it usable in the daily work.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
Other question?
Other questions? Yes. Okay, cool. Thank you all so much for being here.